What's up, fellas? Welcome to the Voltron Watts YouTube channel. My name is Kyle. Today I want to go over this bike. We're going to go over all the parts. We're going to go over the links. We're going to go over the costs. This video is going to be for us bolt-on kings. Nothing wrong with that. You know, we like bikes, we like parts, and we like having fun. Let's do it. All right, boys. So here's the bike. I'm going to go over the price and the parts of everything at the end of the video. I'll have a spreadsheet printed out for you guys to take a look at, and in the description will be a link where all the parts you can find. This is the best bike Amazon ever built. Let's get into it. The bike, the initial cost, I found it locally, lucked out, $150. Oh, first of all, let's get into this. You know, you guys are probably like, what the fuck? Why is he got that shit like that? Well, this bike is getting torn down. I'm going to make it into a MX. But the wires weren't long enough to reach my controller the way I would run it normally. So that's, it is what it is. Front brakes to start in the front. Amazon brakes. They were $45 for the front and rear, all the way front and rear. The disc in the back I found in a kit that I had on a prior build. The front disc, 180 millimeters. That thing is $12, bolts right up to the razor pattern. The fork tubes, the gold parts, those were $113 off of eBay. The triple clamps, the red parts. You can find these from a guy on Facebook. His name is Mike Send. And they bolted right on. They were $108 shipped. The headlight, Amazon special. It came with two. I only have one on right now, but it was $40 for the headlight. The handlebars, also from Amazon, $30 for the handlebars. Bolt right on. These are 28 millimeters at the bolt-on point right there with the risers. The grips, Amazon also, $10. The throttle, this is a domino throttle. Come with a voltmeter. That came from Lone Star Electric. The throttle was $102 shipped. Everything I'm saying here is gonna be shipped with tax, just to keep it simple. The battery, is from Amerage. I'm not even sure I'm saying that right, but it's a 72 volt, 36 amp hour battery. I got a hold of Alan over at Amerage. He hooked it up and that thing was $800 shipped. And with this particular bike, I had to cut out the bottom of this frame in order to make this battery fit. But it's in there. I had to get it in there with a shoehorn. The controller in this one is a Kelly KBD 7212NX from Electro & Co. And that was $180 shipped with tax. It's got a down converter in it so that I can run lights and LEDs and all the fancy things. The down converter was on Amazon and that was $26. The rear shock, also from Amazon, $51. The motor is the Electro & Co. EC4P. That thing was $326 shipped. Rear sprocket, it's a 44 tooth. It's 8 millimeters. It's $18 off of Amazon. And the front sprocket is just the sprocket that came on the motor. That's the stock sprocket. The decals I got off of Etsy, the Ducati decals, those were about $9. The front shield here, I just made this. I just cut that out of a MX fender and kind of bolted it on here just to give it some character with the light on the front. Eventually, if I was gonna keep this bike, I'd have painted it to match the color of the bike. The one thing here, it's kind of hard with these bikes and these bolt patterns, is finding a way to mount brakes. But this brake here came from Jacob Youngblood. He's part of our Ride or Die ATX group here in Austin. He makes these. They bolt on with these mountain bike type brakes. I had to kind of space it out here and there depending on what kind of brake you got and what kind of rotor you got. A couple washers in there, but that works good. Well, that's everything, boys. I wanted to keep it short and sweet for you guys. I value your time and thank you for watching. I appreciate it. If you have any questions, leave them in the comments. I try to answer everybody's comments. I try to engage with the community and people who leave feedback. So those who do, thank you. You're appreciated. One more thing I want to mention is if you have any questions, moving forward about a build, the batteries or controllers, check out the Ride or Die ATX group on the Facebooks. We're a small community of about 25 or 30 people here in the South Austin area who all ride these razors. Give us a follow, interact with us. We're on all the time. We're ready to field questions about whatever you got. Ride or Die ATX, look us up. Later.